Good morning, Apush. Happy Thursday. Today we are going to be addressing an issue that I know we've been having year-round, specifically targeted towards a specific type of short answer question. And this specific issue that I know we've been having is targeting what the main claim is of a secondary source. Now, as a reminder, a primary source is written directly by a historical figure. So, George Washington's farewell address, primary source. Richard Nixon's resignation speech, primary source. A secondary source is written from the perspective of somebody with hindsight that is looking at the historical time period, looking at multiple texts, and synthesizing all of those ideas in the way that you would be reading them. So a secondary source would be, for example, right behind me, it's very large, Ron Chernow's book, Alexander Hamilton. He went through all of Alexander Hamilton's letters, all of the letters from his wife, the letters from everybody that interacted with Hamilton. You have to do a lot of research to get through all of this stuff. And so he went through all of the primary sources related to Alexander Hamilton that he found to be relevant and turned it into one large secondary source, Hamilton, which is what the musical is based on, by the way. So this is a secondary source. And so for us, our issue has been, what is the claim? So what is Chernow's claim in the secondary source? Luckily for short answer questions, you never have to read anything quite this paperweighty. It's pretty big. You guys are usually just reading about a paragraph. So we are going to work together on trying to make sure we understand how to find the claim of a secondary source. So I'm now going to share my screen and do a quick I do while you guys take notes. So now that I have my screen shared, I want you to take one moment, make sure you have your classwork packet available and open so that way you can take notes on how I come to understanding whether or not what the claim is of this Crosby text. So I'm going to give you guys one moment. Please pull up your classwork and be prepared to either type into the classwork document or take notes on a separate piece of paper. I will give you guys 30 more seconds to do so while I get myself set up. Great. So we are going to be looking at finding the claims of secondary source, and I'm going to show you four key steps that I take to understand the claim of a secondary source. And the first is, I'm actually going to skip the secondary source and look at the question. So I'm specifically looking at questions A through C. And I'm going to annotate the question. Unfortunately, I can't annotate the question through Google Docs because this is an image. So I'm just going to tell you guys what I would annotate. So I would annotate that looking at bullet A, it's asking for the similarity in the interpretation of Crosby and West. So I would underline similarity and interpretation of this question. And for this type of short answer question, I need to read each of the passages for claim. So to do that, I'm going to follow these important steps. So first, I'm going to read the source for information and clues. So that's my first step. Read the Next, I am going to determine the topic and scope and make relevant. I can spell the word correctly. Almost as good as a doc cam, much worse than a doc. Okay, And so I noticed that in part C, my questions, I see that the scope is 1491 to 1607. So I'm going to put 1491 to 1607. I know that that's important. Sorry, guys, just one second. Let me look at one. Great, sorry about that. I just needed to review my notes. Let me reshare my screen. Okay, so we know that it is relevant. That is, that we're looking at 1491 to 1607. Now I'm going to start reading the Crosby text for any clues. So in this first two lines, the European pioneers were accompanied and often preceded by their domesticated animals. So I'm, along with the topic and the relevant margin notes, I think it's pretty relevant that I'm looking at Europeans and animals. This leads me to my third step, which is read the passage, believe it or not, to find the author's argument. Beautiful. So now let's read along. As I said, I'm sorry, I can't annotate this because of we can't annotate directly on the Google Doc because it's an image. So I'm going to be reading this document aloud and telling you guys what I would highlight or underline if I was annotating this like with a pen or pencil. So the European pioneers were accompanied and often preceded by their domesticated animals. So I would definitely underline European pioneers and domesticated animals. Walking sources, which were walking sources of food, leather, fiber, power, and wealth. So I would put, I would underline sources because it's telling me that we're looking at the animals specifically as commodities. To a certain extent, the success of the Europeans as colonists was automatic as soon as they put their tough, fast, and fertile and intelligent animals ashore. The latter, dot, 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 sought out their own sustenance, improvised their own protection against the weather, and fought their own battles against predators. I find that the argument of this is pretty clear, which is specifically in this third sentence. So to a certain extent, the success of Europeans as colonists was automatic as soon as they put their animals ashore. So Europe, so my claim is, so my draft of his claim is Europeans are successful in North America because of their animals. And I want us to take note that I'm saying this is the draft of his, of my first, of his claim. So I still need to double check one thing, which is my fourth step to make sure if I have his claim correctly. Correct. So next I have to determine if the author is refuting another's statement or refuting a topic. So determine if the author is refuting a topic. So this is what I mean by I need to determine if this is truly his, this is a draft of his claim. So I'm going to look through the rest of his source and I'm going to look for words like terms like however, on the other hand, nevertheless, etc. So if those types of terms are lacking, then great, we have our claim. And so I'm gonna look through the second half of this source and I don't see any however, it looks like in the second half of this, he's just backing up his original claim that we found in that third sentence. So we have our claim. So Crosby's claim. Crosby's claim is Europeans were successful in North America because of the resources their animals provided. Great, so we have Crosby's claim. I have done this to show you guys the different steps that we take. Please take 15 seconds to make sure you have all four of these steps written down, as well as what Crosby's claim is. Go and take a few seconds to make sure you have everything in there. Pause the video if you need. Great. And now I'm going to ask that you guys pause this video, practice on West's text. This should take you about 3 minutes. So pause this video, set a timer for 3 minutes. Try to find the claim of West, and then join this video again to determine if you found the accurate claim. So please pause this video. When you come back, I'm going to tell you whether or not you identified the claim correctly. Great, so now we are going to be specifically looking at West's claim. And West's claim, let's see if we have it correct, is that the horse introduced by Europeans positively transformed the lives of Native Americans. Great. So please check to see if you have that claim correctly attributed. If it is not, please find the error between your claim and my exemplar claim. Now I'm going to show you guys very, very quickly how we would use these understanding these claims in order to answer the questions. So I'm not going to write this in full sentences for the sake of time, but if I were to answer similarities, what the similarity is between Crosby and West, now that I have their claims accurately figured out, I definitely would say like their similarity is just animals are important. And run the success of these civilizations in North America. Again, in a short answer question on the AP exam, I would take my time and I would spend at least 2 to 3 sentences justifying why that is a similarity. And then in terms of the difference is Crosby focuses on animals' aid to Europeans, whereas West focuses on natives. Again, I would spend 2 to 3 sentences figuring that out. And notice that just by finding the claims of these two authors correctly, I already have 2 out of my 3 points. So I already have a majority of this figured out. Okay, now briefly explain how one example from the period of 1491 to 1607, not explicitly mentioned in these excerpts, could be used to support one of these two historians' interpretations. So again, this is something that can't be explicitly listed from in this thing. Something I can think of that can justify both of these authors is just the Columbian Exchange, where new civilizations exchanged goods. Obviously, there is a better way to say that, but again, I'm just showing you guys how using their claims is going to help you answer these questions. So I just want to push for you guys to see that just by finding the author's claim, you are getting 2 out of these 3 points. And more than likely, at least one of your short answer questions on the AP exam is going to have secondary sources. So this is a skill that is super, super necessary. So we are going to be spending the rest of the class period working on understanding secondary source claims. So you are going to have, where you guys should be taking notes. So you guys are going to do a couple rounds of practice before we transition to our exit ticket here at the very end. So make sure you are answering all four pieces and then telling me what the claim is. Make sure you are following all four steps. Make sure that you have this filled out for when you'd practice with West. I look forward to seeing your guys' results. Please hop on Zoom if you are having any issues with learning how to find a secondary source claim. I am there to help you and to be a resource. I look forward to seeing you guys on Zoom and improving our short answer questions related to secondary sources. Awesome. I'll see you guys later.